Hello again, everybody. It is Gordon Majak here, back with another episode of Timeless Pop, Rock, and Soul. And today we are going back to late 1972, early 1973 for the living definition of power pop. Remember that sound back in the day? Power pop. Here it is. This is where it started, if you ask me. This is, of course, Eric Carmen. Remember that name? Eric Carmen and his band. This is, of course, Eric Carmen. Remember that name? Eric Carmen and his band, The Raspberries, and their second album, Fresh Raspberries. And we are going to hear this little number right here, one of my favorites from the early 70s, a song called Let's Pretend. Now, the thing about Eric Carmen and the Raspberries, of course, they came busting out of the chute there in 1972 prior to this album. This is their second album. And their first album had that monster hit and really just a defining moment of power pop, a song called Go All the Way. Remember that one by Eric Carmen and the Raspberries? Go All the Way. All the way up to number five right out of the gate for the Raspberries and really put themselves on the map as a force for some pretty catchy hit records. And Eric Carmen, of course, establishing himself as a guy that had a knack for writing hit songs and singing the hell out of them as well. Quite a charismatic lead singer as well for Eric Carmen. Now, of course, he went on later on here to a solo career, and you may remember his most defining moments of a solo artist from 1975 there, his iconic signature song, All By Myself. Remember that one from 1975? That one got all the way up to number two. And then about 12 years later in 1987, here comes Eric Carmen all over again, out of nowhere, really, at that point, on that Dirty Dancing soundtrack. And he had that big hit song, Hungry Eyes, and that was a number four hit record for Eric Carmen. So you put it all together and look at his career, and the guy clearly had a knack for writing these kind of really dramatic, catchy as hell, melodic pop songs, and it's kind of a guilty pleasure. But going all the way back there to the beginning, you know, after the success of Go All the Way, their first big hit, a top five hit, as I said. And if you would have asked me, I really would have thought, just based on my own memory of hearing this song, Let's Pretend, from their second album, I would have thought, just going off of my memory, that this song was a much bigger hit than the charts have since indicated to me. Because when I look it up, I see that this song only got up to number 35. And following up a big hit like Go All the Way, top five hit single, you'd think they had a pretty good dose of momentum there coming into 1973 when they released Let's Pretend. But not so much the case. Not necessarily a huge hit, but man, a song that I sure remember and a song that I actually like even more than Go All the Way. And Let's Pretend, this was just a record that when you heard this on the radio in the car, man, this was an instant reach for the volume and crank it. This song just sounded so fantastic coming out of a car stereo, an AM radio in the car, especially if you had a nice big boomy one. Just a great sound for Eric Carmen and the Raspberries from 1973. I've had this one floating around on my playlist, in and out of my playlist here forever, and I've been dying to get to it, and I always seem to find something else at the last second. But today we are going to do it. It is, well, there's another picture of these guys. And there's Eric Carmen right there. And I saw a video or something of him, and he actually sounded pretty good live. I was surprised what a good singer he was live. From March of 1973, it is Eric Carmen and the Raspberries and that iconic power pop sound of Let's Pretend.
Say, oh no, fading away.
Well, it's pretty easy to see where Eric Carmen got all the inspiration for those hooks, right? I mean, you take the Beatles' great pop tunes, pop rock tunes of the mid-60s there, the Beach Boys as well, and you roll it all up together with, excuse me, a lot of the UK artists there that came out of the British invasion. And there's Eric Carmen soaking all that stuff up and rolling it up into a nice big fat one. And just some of the catchiest stuff you will ever hear. Those verses and those choruses make you just want to start singing them almost immediately when you hear this great old stuff here by Eric Carmen. The definition of power pop back there in the day, right? And it's kind of funny that if I think back like mid-late 90s, didn't that vibe sort of come back around there for a little while? Wasn't there a number of power pop bands on the scene then as well, right? They probably learned a few things from Eric Carmen. You crank up those really melodic verses and those great choruses, catchy choruses. You put some real emotional melodramatic vocals on there. Big drums and jangly guitars. It works every single time since the mid-60s. And Eric Carmen certainly milked it for all it was worth there in the early 70s and then went out on his own, as I said, and scored a couple pretty big hits on the solo side as well. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, I think he's still out there touring and performing to this day. I may have seen a video of him performing live somewhere. I can't remember where, but I know I saw something. So Eric Carmen still on the scene, and I think he still sounds pretty good, too. Oh, yeah. God, that stuff sounded good back in the day on the car radio, man. Go All the Way. You couldn't crank that one loud enough. And ditto here for Let's Pretend with the Raspberries. And the great Eric Carmen. See you in the next one, folks. Hope you dug that little nugget. That is just a guilty pleasure all the way around, isn't it? A little ear candy, pop candy there from Eric Carmen. See you, folks.